Hello fellow tankers, in this video I will address the Tunisia map, which is for me one of the most badly played map in the game, with similar maps like Korea and Fulda. The reason for that is that very often you will find that the large majority of players are essentially not contributing to the win. Let me explain that in detail. So this map is an horizontal map in the sense that the three caps are at equal distance from the two spawns. But like in many such maps, you have two maps which are connected, in the sense that first it's very easy to go from one to the other by many ways, from the water, from here, from the top. But it's also very easy to defend and attack these two caps together, whereas the sea is much more isolated. You access to sea from another set of spawns, and it's obviously possible to go from B to C, but it's a long and tedious drive, and you can be actually shot from almost everywhere. So in practice, people who go to sea either die or go to the enemy spawn, which is essentially useless. So you will see that almost systematically the winning team has A and B at the end of the day. Sometimes they have C also, but generally when you get A, which is the most important cap, you will get B. It's very rare that this battle is won by a team getting B and C or A and C. Usually you will see that almost systematically the winning team has A and B. So that means that in the beginning of the game, essentially one half of the team should go in this area, and a few tanks, one or two, should go to B, and a few tanks, let's say typically five, should go to C. But the idea is maybe not even go to C. I mean, try to exploit these hills, and to be patient and sneaky in C rather than having, like you will see in many games, half of the two teams going to C and having a pretty straightforward fight. So let me address the access to the three caps. So from the green side, the fastest way to go to A is to take this path here, to go on this side of the rock. Sorry. Side of the rock, and then coming under the bridge. You can also go from the water here, and later in the game, if especially if A is controlled by the enemy, or if you have slow tanks, you can go also this way from the red side. You can go the direct way, but you need really fast tanks, because when you pass here, you may be seen by some tanks already here. In IBR, for instance, in top BR, the safest way from the red side is to go this way and then through the water. Again, later in the game, it can be useful to have one or two tanks coming this way and shooting from these two corners. It's actually a very good way to shoot at enemy tanks which would be in the water, or even which would be in this area. So that covers the access to A. The access to B, from the green side, you can take in low BR the direct access essentially here and cap around here. In higher BR, in especially in top BR, if you go this way, you will be probably sniped by a tank coming fast in this area. So generally in IBR, I'm going a bit more first to the east, and I'm coming down then this way. And the idea is to put this rock between me and campers, which would be already here. Let me mention that in the beginning of the game, I very, very often go to B. The idea is that not only by capping B, where generally there will be very few players, I can start the ticket bleed, but I have also a good and pretty safe approach to attack A from the water, which is the very, very efficient way, effective way to attack A. From the right side, you have the in low BR fast access to B here, even if you have to cross a bit of water. But again, as the BR increases, this direct approach will be much more dangerous. And generally, I prefer going this way and then this way, where I will be protected in this area, and also when I emerge, protected from the by this rock. There is just a few meters where the campers, which would be here in IBR, can see you. So, but very often they will shoot at other campers, maybe are not ready to shoot. So between shots, you have just a very few meters, not even 10 meters, that you have to cross, which are dangerous. But as soon as you are here, you are covered by the rock. Let me address the access to C and the fight on C, because essentially, again, on this map, C is irrelevant. So the access is pretty straightforward. Very often, you will find that, especially the red tanks, like to go on the east part of C. And I think that for some of the players, the hope is ultimately to see the spawn. It's honestly much better to go on the west side of C in this area. And you will see the reason in a second is that if you have so first coming, for instance, from here, from the red side, here you have actually the best view on green tanks, which would be in this area, which is a much better view than coming from this side. The idea is that you have also to contain red tanks, green tanks coming from here. And when this area is controlled, and even if you have a few green tanks remaining in this area, my advice is that you go toward the this bridge and essentially block green tanks reinforcement, which will be pinned by one or two red tanks at this corner. It's very hard to dislodge not too stupid players playing at this corner, whereas the other corner here is much less effective. So it's actually much less effective to attack C from this side. And similarly for the green side, so the idea is that from here again, so this area is very important for both sides, you can shoot very effectively at red tanks, which would be here. And later, once the area is a bit clean, you go here and you essentially take this position where you will contain very effectively tanks, red tanks emerging from the bridge, and essentially you will pin the red tanks behind the bridge. Whereas again, if you come from this side, this This corner is much less effective. Let me mention that in the domination map, when you have control the area of C, of course, two tanks should be at the corner here to block the access from the bridge. It's honestly completely stupid to go to the enemy cap, to the enemy spawn. It's generally much too early in the game. The game is not won. When the game is not won, don't go to enemy spawn. And let me mention that if a team has completely controlled the area and is in your spawn, don't spawn in the spawn, and actually spawn on the other side where A and B are, and where the battle will be won. I very often see one team controlling the entire area, going quite stupidly to the enemy spawn, and even more stupidly, the team which has been wiped out from this area is respawning, and of course is dying. So there is a lot of really stupid play on C generally. So instead of going to enemy spawn again, block the entrance of the bridge. Just two, three tanks are enough to do that. And all the other tanks should essentially leave C and try to go cover B or attack B. But here the terrain is not that easy, the camping spots are not that good. That's why, I mean, definitely in the beginning of the game, not too many tanks should go to C. And again, at the end of the day, capping C is essentially absolutely not important. The team which holds A generally holds B. Let me mention that, unfortunately, in practice, typically we'll have half of the team on C. It's a bit of caricature, and the other half of the team camping over A. So at the end of the day, that explains why generally this map is very badly played and can be actually won by very few active players. So let me mention here that camping over A here is pretty useless, especially from the green side. I have to say there are a bit better spot from the red side, and again that's the idea that when campers are shooting at other campers, they are generally useless. When campers are shooting at active players, they are useful, but when they are shooting at campers, they are essentially useless. The idea is that if you remove them from their hills and just J them out, well, the battle is essentially the same. Essentially, these people here do not contribute anything in the battle. Let me mention, so that I already mentioned that A is the most important cap, and ideally something like half of the team should go there, but again not to camp, but actually to take the good positions, especially in the water. I like in RB, especially when you have a small team match, to ambush after capping, to ambush enemies in this area. It's very efficient. It works obviously not as well in arcade. This passage here is very important. The idea is that from this passage you can really cover a wide area over B. From the two sides, red or green tanks, so it's very important, and you can even cover people exiting from the city. It's extremely strong spot, but Honestly, in the middle of the battle, people shooting from here to here or from here to here, it's actually a very bad and very dangerous position. So the idea is that fighting for this passage is indeed a good idea, but really to actually control this area and be helpful on B, rather than just to shoot from here to here, which are just two bad positions. There are camping spots, especially in IBR, over this region, and definitely very few campers should be there to actually cover B, but really not too many. Two should be enough, and the same from the red side, maybe one camper here and one camper in this area. That's well enough. But really controlling the river and really navigating between A and B to be sure to hold both of them, remembering that attacking A from the river is extremely effective. Let me mention actually a camping spot I hate when there are players there, especially in IBR. So again, it's a camping spot for only one person. I guess it's something around here. I never went there. It's not really my style to spend my whole game 100 meters from the spawn. But I know that in IBR there is a camping spot in this area, which is pretty annoying when you are fighting for B. Let me quickly address the conquest maps. So here, essentially, I mean, you have to really fight for A and really fight for A in the water also. In most games, you will have a lot of campers on both sides. You have to fight for this area, but again, here green has a little advantage because it has a good cover to this region, and the idea is actually to go this way, and for red this way, to actually infiltrate the river and offer a new angle to fight. The fight of B, essentially, you have to really rush the cap, and it's actually so sorry. When B is the only cap in a conquest mode, you have really to rush the cap, and it's if you have people on the other side of B, it's actually not too easy, despite the campers, which shows that they are not very useful, to actually navigate, move on the cap, and to exploit the river, the different rocks, to actually make your way to kill enemy tanks in this area. That goes for red and that goes for green. Let me say that when B is the only cap in a conquest mode, this area of the map again is very important, especially this passage, which has a very good view over the hill. As when C is the conquest map, is the only ma cap in a conquest map, the fight is inside the city. There is simply no point in going anywhere else than inside the city. So let me switch to the replay. I'm playing my 6.3 Italian lineup, which I have already featured in the Carilia video, which was actually just a very few battles before this game. I have actually described a bit the Italian tech tree. So, with these two videos, I have now played all nations in my tutorial. So here, I took the most direct way to B, which was actually a bit dangerous. I mentioned previously that there is a way by first going a bit more to the east, which is much safer, which allows you to to have a much safer approach to me. So let's look a bit at the map. So you see we have unfortunately a lot of campers, not too many people on sea. These three campers which are not very useful because we are not at IBR. Anyway, you need only maybe this camper, maybe one or two campers here, and people should have come much faster to the river. So I'm a bit pinned on B by this Carnarvon, but it seems that he will be. Let me accelerate a bit. So this you will see that this replay is actually quite interesting. It starts slowly. I have to tell you that in the beginning of the game I'm a bit pessimistic because I see that we have a lot of very passive players in the team, and one guy who is doing one or two guys who are doing a good good job on sea. Actually, when you have two good players on sea, or three, four good players on sea, it's okay. But when half of the team, or even more than half of the team, sometimes go there, it's really annoying. So here I'm shooting with my hit, with a huge penetration. This is two on the side, and it does absolutely nothing. When I speeded this Fiat, I really enjoyed it, and really the shell was very deadly. And during this session, I was have to admit that I was a bit disappointed by this shell. I don't know if it was nerfed, but obviously I didn't have a very good result with this tank, which is just a very difficult gun handling, which is not as mobile as the R3 at BR70. So you see that I just tracked the guy, but my recollection was that that kind of shot would have made a big splash and should have killed the enemy tank. So here, now my shot is swallowed by the rock, and you see that the situation is deteriorating. We lost the sea again. We have three campers over sea, but which are really not very useful. Two brave guys on sea, but they were visibly overrun. And here I make a mistake. I should have stayed behind the I should have stayed behind the rock, and I'm dying slowly but surely. So as you can see, it's not a great start for the game, and we are actually now losing B also. So we have a very passive team, except for my squad mate Arium, who is playing his Swedish lineup, and he's from Sweden, so he's happy to have a new tank. So except for the two active guys on sea, but who just died, and our squad, the team is extremely passive over A. And even over sea, we have too many campers, three campers. This guy is respawning, he has just been killed on sea. And here we have really too many campers. I have definitely one or two campers over B, but look, we have, honestly, we have one, two, three campers from the start. This guy just respawn. One, two, three campers from the other side, and yet the enemy cap B without any problem. So again, if campers are not useful to to threaten the access of the enemy to a cap, they are essentially useless. So they could have probably done a better job, but six campers over the seals is too many. And this guy here is useless, this guy is in a bad position. And here we have a clutter, two free tanks here is too many. Maybe they could have helped Arium. Maybe and you see nobody is coming over B. Well, this game is definitely starting badly. So my goal here is to go back to B, not only to cap it, but also to offer another access, another angle to attack A, to come from the water. And here I'm choosing this path because of the T95. So I'm playing 6.3 lineup, and I think we are in a 7-3 game, if I remember. So the SCA-1 is fighting with my buddy Arium, and so I'm moving to propose another angle, and it's very hard for one tank, this poor SCA-1. Who actually killed me previously, to fight two enemies which are at a 90 degree angle. So very often when you have one of your allies shooting at a tank, try not to come behind him and to bump into him and make him miss his shot. Try to help by proposing another angle, and which will be much more helpful. So here, first I'm capping. Let me accelerate a bit. But again, you saw that essentially so far the only cap which has been captured by our team was this B spot, but which is not yet very useful, since our team has lost ANC. So there are unfortunately two tanks which are pinning me in on B. The FV is obviously the most dangerous, so I'm trying to learn the FV to shoot. I'm hoping that he will shoot. He did, he missed, obviously. And the M18, I'm not too worried, and I killed the M18. At this point, at this point, when I want to maybe attack the FV 4202 from the other side to surprise him, but there is unfortunately still the C95. My shot was obviously useless, since and absolutely no chance of penetrating it, at least without aiming very carefully. And here the heavy really makes a mistake. Instead of really waiting for me and concentrating his attention on me, he let me kill him by a shot on the top of the turret. And you see that it's very easy to navigate between A and B once you have killed these guys. Let me mention something here, is that this position here should be used to help to dislodge red tanks here. And here, honestly, my squad mate made an error by fighting here with the tank which was here. He made an error and died, actually. So the red tank is coming up, and instead of going to B or waiting for me here, he's going up, which is obviously a mistake. My squad mate should have really gone here and help me dislodge this heavy a bit quicker, but we didn't agree on that. But I think at the end he recognized that that would have been a better option. So now I'm coming from the river to attack A, and you see that our tickets are bleeding. I bounce on the M4, this fight. But my shot was anyway not very good, because I actually was shooting on the loader side, which was the only side I could see. And I uncap A just before we lose all our tickets. In the same time, C is a bit just after, you see. C is being uncapped, but C is not important. You don't need three caps to win a game, you need two caps. And unfortunately, instead of you see that B is completely open, if an enemy goes to B, had gone to B before, and especially the heavy tank which was close to A, we would have lost this game. We don't need C. And let's see the ticket situation. You see that we have 204 tickets left. And remember, many people in the game seems not to know that every time you kill a tank, the enemy team lose 100 tickets. So that means that if we have only 204 tickets, that means that if three tanks die in our team, we lose. And unfortunately, many people are not aware of that, and we are writing, Arium and myself, in the chat, and as you see, one guy died very stupidly on A instead of hiding behind inside the arch of the bridge. And if you look at the tickets at this point, we have 104 tickets left, and soon, unfortunately, only 4 tickets. And meanwhile, what we are doing, Arium and myself, is just to try to contain this MX-13 on the top. If he goes down, I will kill him. If he goes toward Arium, he will kill him. So you see, we have only 4 tickets left. One guy died on C. I'm writing again, that's why I don't move. Previously, I say, don't die! One more death and we have lost the game. The MX-13 is trying for a push. And here, Arium will be very careful and will kill the the MX-13, and finally the enemy team has lost all these tickets, and we have 4 tickets left, and we win this game with the very good contribution, obviously, of 2 players who essentially fought on C. But again, unfortunately, these 2 guys would have been much more helpful fighting on A and B. I don't really approve the fact that taking SPA in a tough game at the end of a tough game, but maybe this guy took the SPA at the end seeing that we have capped A and B to maybe kill planes. If so, that was actually not bad, so very good game for Mr. LXL and Mr. Bunny. Okay game here, good game from Arium, and unfortunately you see that, maybe except this player, the rest of our team has been completely useless. Mostly the people who camped over C and over A, Whereas, as you can see, the kills are much more evenly distributed in the enemy team. Again, someone taking SPA where in such a difficult battle where only one kill would have changed the outcome of the game is a bit a shame. All right, so thank you for watching this tutorial, and I hope that you find it interesting and that you enjoyed this this tense battle, and see you in battle.